is it.
This is it.
Thank you. I'm very happy to be here tonight to help honor a lady who made my entry into this world a media event. When my mother was pregnant with me, you couldn't even say the word pregnant on television. But that didn't stop Mom. She had been filming I Love Lucy and had been carrying me for about 4 months. She and Dad decided, for the sake of the storylines, that whatever I turned out to be, the baby on television should be a boy. Well, when Mom makes up her mind, she usually gets her way. And sure enough, they really did have a boy.
Ta-da!
Anyway, when I was 15 years old, my sister and I had a chance to work with Mom on the Here's Lucy show. How many kids can get their education from the best there is? Well, that's what we got. I love you, Mom, and I'm very proud of you tonight. My sister Lucy wanted very much to be here tonight. She's appearing back east in a new Broadway production of The Guardsman, and she couldn't get away. But being brought up in the television generation, she knew there was a way to be here without really being here. And so, through the magic of videotape, here is my sister and her mother's daughter, Lucy Arnaz.
They said, I mean, talk about your getting the breaks. From the tip of her toes to the top of her head, she's got what it takes. But of course she's gonna act. She's got all the biological means. Why, her chromosomes all are impressively stacked with purebred showbiz genes. Just look at her mother, they said. Is that not her mother's kid? Look at her mother, they said, and everybody did. Look at her mother, I heard for the first time when I was a tot, which was not for the last time. I should have known then I was in for the worst time, cause looking at Mom was a national pastime. Let me tell you about my mother, the star, the lady who's known near and far as a brilliant buffoon, the superlative clown, remarkable mimic, the toast of this town, producer and singer and studio head. She's simply superb, that's what everyone said. She is what she is, and I am what I am. Growing up in the biz with my mother, the star. Your dad is a doctor, you'll find as a rule, you may be enrolled. and able as Abdul-Jabbar. She's a red-headed wonder, legs up to here, took all that beauty, made a career. From pratfalls and fright wigs, making you cry, and doing odd things no one's mother would try. She is what she is, 'cause she takes it that far. He's the best in the business, that's my mother, the star.
You know, this should be very therapeutic for me, being able to talk to so many of you at one time about my mom, and to get a chance to tell the truth about what it really feels like to be stopped on the street and detained in ladies' rooms, cornered in grocery stores, all the time by smiling, happy folk who recognize me and say, you're, and I say, yes, and they say, yes, Lucille Ball's daughter. That doesn't happen that often. Just as many times when people have come up and recognized me and said, you're Lucy Arnaz, right? And that does make me very happy. And then they say, I love your mother. I don't want to sound like sour grapes. I'm sure there are just as many times when people have come up and recognized me and said, I love your dad. Or your brother, Desi. Or your sister, Liza. And now this. They're putting my mother into the TV Hall of Fame. I mean, I ask you, how would you feel if your mother had been plaqued and Emmy'd and commemorated and citationed and awarded, magnified, deified, woman of the year, all of your natural life? I don't know how you'd feel, but I'll tell you how I feel. Proud and happy and delighted and thrilled at being so close to that woman that I call my mother, the star, whose antics are sometimes bizarre. But when we were together at work on the set, she taught me some lessons I'll never forget about rhythm and timing and working with zest, taking the punches, giving your best. That's why she's so great, a star like no other. I'm delighted to state that star is my mother. The warmest, the wisest, the sweetest, the dearest of women that I ever knew. You know how much I wanted to be there tonight to share this great moment with you. But one of the things you taught me about this business was, when you get a paying job, don't leave town for anything. But there is someone out there who has been almost like a member of the family over the years, and she wouldn't have missed this opportunity for anything in the world. Carol Burnett.
I can see you out there. You are dissolved after that. I just hope someday my kids do the same thing for me. You deserve every accolade in the world. I love you. I'm so proud to be here. And if you weren't being inducted tonight into the Hall of Fame, a concept that is as bizarre as some of the predicaments she got herself into on her television shows, I mean, if by some chance she weren't, Lucy would be here tonight anyway, applauding and cheering with all of those and for all of those who were nominated, because Lucy is a fan. I was first the recipient of that zeal in New York City. The second night of a show that I was in off-Broadway called Once Upon a Mattress. and Lucy made it a point to come see the show. I was a wreck. It was like the mountain making a point to come see Muhammad. And she not only saw the show, but she came backstage afterwards to my dressing room, and she spent a whole hour talking to me and giving me advice and encouragement and friendship. How many mountains do you know that do that? She called me the kid. She still does. Thank you. Someone who didn't know us once asked me to describe my feelings about Lucille Ball. And I said, if I could be anybody in the world, I would like to be half the woman she is, and I still say that. The face that has been seen by more people more often than the face of any human being who ever lived looked like this back in Celeron, New York, a few years after her birth, the 6th of August, of mixed Irish, Scottish, English, and French ancestry, Lucille Desiree Ball was a beauty from the word go. She used to venture out from this house to go to vaudeville shows and movies in Jamestown, and then came home and she'd act out all the parts. Dee Dee, her mom, was a strong supporter of Lucy's all of her life and encouraged her to go to New York at the age of 15 to study dramatics. She was terrified and spellbound by the school's star pupil, Betty Davis, and hurried back home after only 6 weeks. However, she returned to New York periodically and had limited success on Broadway, turning to modeling to pay the bills. Getting national exposure as the Chesterfield cigarette girl enabled her to come to Hollywood, replacing one of the Goldwyn girls in the Eddie Cantor film, Roman Scandal. Lucy served one of the longest apprenticeships in movies, appearing in dozens of B pictures, but always learning from the best and always doing her best while learning. Her mom was with her through this entire period. And in one of the films, Too Many Girls, she met a Cuban band leader and bongo player named Desi Arnaz. And in 1940, they were married. It took 11 years, but on October 15th, 1951, one of the most improbable combinations in show business became one of the most successful with the television debut of I Love Lucy.
Look, tell me something. Do you play the sin?
Who's that?
I say, do you play the sin?
What sin?
Never mind making fun of my English.
That's English.
Yes, with Vitamita Benjamin, you can spoon your way to health. All you do is take a tablespoonful after every meal.
Now you take some.
Oh. It's so tasty, too.
Devotion to the best this medium is capable of, and for her enormous heart that reaches out with humor and love to millions of people whose lives would be decidedly duller without her shining presence, the Television Academy is honored to welcome into the Hall of Fame Lucille Ball.
Thank you.
My kids put me away enough. Don't overdo it. Boy, this is really a great evening. I didn't know what to expect. Did you? I see dozens of friendly faces that have meant so much to me over the years. I have had several memorable evenings, many rewards for doing something I have loved doing, and I am, besides being very nervous right now, I am very aware that I have been absolutely blessed by having many talented and creative people surrounding me. We all know we never do anything alone. Oh boy, I wish a lot of them could be here tonight. This night has got to top them all. Imagine the first Television Academy Hall of Fame. And to be in the company of such illustrious names. I really am very grateful, first of all, to all of America. And I am in awe of this occasion. I love you all very much. Thank you.